We're live. We are live. Good evening, good night, good day, wherever you are. My name is Harry Marie, and we are live on Instagram for Mocktails with Harry. So we're gonna wait a few minutes for my friends to trickle in. How are you doing? How are you all doing? Please let me know if you hear me. It's very essential to know if you guys hear me or not. I want to post this comment. I am. I'm going to post it. I'm going to pin it. Oh man, I'm really excited for this one. I mean, I'm excited every week to be with you all, but this one is really fun. The name I came up with, of course, based on the ingredients, but also it reminds me, hey Cree, it reminds me of my grandmother. We actually call my grandmother Gigi, but it's spelled G-I-G-I, and this drink is like, just the ingredients alone is kind of like classy. So it's definitely like my grandmother, like gives you like a little punch, sweet, tangy, refreshing, cool. Yeah, she's definitely this drink. I gotta tell her that I made a drink. I gave her a name. I named the drink after her. But yeah, so welcome you all. Thank you for joining me. My name is Harry Marie, and this week for Mocktails with Harry, we are creating and conversing over the Gigi Slush. So you kind of hear in the name, it's a frozen drink. This will be our second one that we did. We did a raspberry frozen cheesecake some time ago. And you know, summertime, you definitely, you know, frozen drink is definitely a theme for the summer. So yeah, thanks for the hearts and the likes, and I appreciate it. If you have any questions about any of the ingredients or in general, definitely click one of those icons at the bottom of your phone or screen, wherever you're looking from. I think it has a question mark on it. And you know, so I can be notified if you have a question. But again, hi Sylvia, thanks for joining me. All right, let's get into it. I'll wait one more minute. So how is you all's day? Oh my God, I'm also pretty excited because I have like a little surprise that I wanna share with you. I got a gift this week and I feel so loved. It's like the perfect color and everything. It's gonna make Mocktails with Harry that much smoother and better. And of course I'll be even more excited to make drinks. Hey Jade. So before we get into it, I was washing dishes this week, and you know, I don't know if you guys know, but those of you who are here every week will know that I kind of switch between my blender, or my, as my friend Cree calls it, the Chinese food container. It cracked. Can you guys believe it? My makeshift home Chinese food container shaker cracked. But the thing about it is that it was okay because I got this. I got this freaking beauty. Ah. Isn't it beautiful? Oh my God. Oh my God, it's so lit. Like, it has my colander strainer, it has my cocktail shaker cover, it has the cocktail pourer, the cocktail course shaker, so that I could. Then we have our ice scoop. We have a jigger. Maybe this is a opener? I've never used one, so it's so sophisticated, so excited to use it. Then we have our wine bottle opener. Oh my God. bag lit. We got some pourers here. A muddler. So I guess I won't be using my spoon. Excited. It's so official. Like, and then I got my spoon. Man, my bar is gonna be lit. And then we have the other strainer. So now when I'm double straining, it's gonna be seamless. But yeah, so let's begin. Welcome again. This is Muffins with Harry. My name is Harry Marie, and you can find me across social at Harry Marie and harrymarie.com. So we're making the GG slush today. Can anyone guess what the GG stands for? I mean, if you got the recipe, then that's cool. But if you didn't, you could definitely take a stab at what the GG stands for. We definitely use one of the ingredients with one of our earlier recipes. And I think this is the first time I'm actually using a second ingredient in the recipe. Oh no, not the first time. Anyway, it is for grapefruit and ginger ale. Now, and it's gonna be frozen. All right, so ingredients. So I have my ginger ale, which I have in the freezer chilling along with my blender glass, because I want it to be extra cold when I blend it so that it keeps that frozen vibes and it's not going into a warm glass. So let me get that right now. So I have my ginger ale. I have boiling ginger ale. You can get any ginger ale brand. I'm trying to get more of a, like, with like less sugar and less synthetic ingredients. So this one is made with cane sugar and as minimal ingredients as possible. That's what I like. Then we have our fresh grapefruits. I do have grapefruit juice. But I wanted to go fresh today, so I mean, I have my bottled ginger ale, so I can go fresh with the fruit. And then we have our vanilla extract. Now, the thing about this drink is that it's made typically with bourbon or whiskey, so and then rosemary to garnish, along with our fresh grapefruit. Now, here's the thing. How did we get from bourbon whiskey to vanilla extract? Well, vanilla extract is so strong, you can replace bourbon whiskey in any of your drinks with vanilla extract. You can also replace it with pineapple juice. You can also replace it with peach syrup and also orange juice. I chose vanilla extract because I really wanted to get close to that bourbon whiskey smoky taste. And for me, the peach pineapple juice, which I'm allergic to, and pineapple, even though I had it over this weekend and I'm quite fine. But I wanted a real punch for this drink, which is gonna be frozen, and you're gonna have all this ice, and then you're gonna have the fruit juice, and then you're gonna have the ginger ale. And so anything for me that will make it even a little bit stronger of a drink, that's what I wanted to do. So the vanilla extract was my choice. But again, yes, rosemary. If you want to not use vanilla extract, you can use pineapple, you can use orange juice, you can use a peach syrup. If you need me to share how to make a peach syrup, DM me and welcome. I'm definitely able to share how to do that. So yeah, the rosemary here, which is such a like woody, piney smell, it really enhances the grapefruit. Think about grapefruit and rosemary, like you can actually detox. If you're doing like a detox ever and you want something that's kind of herbaceous. Look it up. You can use the rosemary and the grapefruit juice in water, and you can drink that as a detox drink. I think it's pretty cool. And without the ginger, you could also use just the grapefruit, get some honey or agave. I like agave. It's naturally not healthier than sugar or healthier than honey, but I want to save the bees and try to save as much things as possible. Even though, like I said before, you're technically, you know, cutting down cacti. And I mean, who's growing cacti fast enough? So, oh my gosh. Anywho, let's get into it. So, I also have a large grapefruit juice, a green grapefruit, that I'm gonna use instead. I'm gonna use my large grapefruit. And I'm gonna use my citrus juicer because I don't wanna have to squeeze this manually. I wanna get as much juice as out of it as possible. Yeah, it could be a little dirty. Don't mind me. So here we go. Here's my citrus juicer. I'm going to get all the juice out of it. Ooh. I'm gonna squeeze it. Now we need 4 ounces of grapefruit juice. And I probably would have gotten. I'm getting all the juices out. Squeezing it and shaking it. Those of you who are joining us, we are now juicing the grapefruit for our GG Slush, which is a grapefruit and ginger ale mocktail. Okay, that's good to see. So I'm gonna definitely need all that's out of there. Would you have gotten that if you manually squeezed that? I don't think so. I'm all about making life simpler. This is what I got so far. I think I want a little bit more. You know, I'm gonna have a drink tomorrow. Ooh, yeah, baby. So yeah, I use this to juice my oranges. Basically all citrus, because what else is round and will give you juices other than limes, lemons? I use every morning for my lemon water, lime water, before I start my day. That's my kind of detox. It helps me not drink too much sugar. Okay. I think I have enough here. So this drink calls for more of any of the liquid. So usually when you're making a drink that's non-ice based, non-frozen, you're gonna use like 2 ounces, 1 ounce, a half an ounce, because a typical glass, typical drink with ice on the rocks is usually 8 ounces, 6 to 8 ounces. So if you were using, if you were like blending it, you would be using a lot less of the ginger ale and grapefruit and all that stuff. We'll get into that. All right, so let me get my chilled blender glass. Oh my gosh. When I put the ingredients in there, it's like not going to be it's gonna stay as chilled as possible. And I gotta shout out my sister for getting me an extra glass for my birthday. I can't even lie. When you have 2 glasses, one is dirty in the sink and one is clean, oh my god, like it just calls for not washing dishes. Or times like this. Alright, so let us begin. We are going to use 4 ounces of the ginger ale. Again, our jigger, one side is 1 ounce, the smaller side, the other side is 2 ounces. I'm gonna use my rose gold new set. Again, bigger side is 2 ounces, smaller side is 1 ounce. I'm gonna use two sides of the 2 ounces. So, and this one, oh my God, this one has the line in it so that you can know how much is half an ounce. A little bit more. It doesn't hurt. Ginger. They're gonna use 4 ounces of the grapefruit juice. Then we're going to add 7 ice cubes. I'll be right back to get that. I have a bowl with that in the fridge. Now, for our kicker, we're gonna use 6 teaspoons of vanilla extract. If you were gonna use an alcohol, like bourbon or whiskey, which this drink also calls for, you would use 2 ounces. So 6 teaspoons of vanilla extract is equivalent to 2 ounces of bourbon or whiskey. I had to sit down and do my math, because I'm like, wait, I gotta figure this out. So we're gonna do 6 teaspoons. 4, 5, 6. Oh my god. Like when you're smelling it, actually, like I'm smelling it and putting it in there, I can see why you can replace the vanilla extract with the instead of for bourbon. Like I was like, and how did I figure out? I had to read. I had to really read, and I had to investigate what I could use instead of bourbon that would give me that great kick. All right, give me one moment. I'm gonna blend. Basically adding water, but let's see, I can always add. Yeah, not even moving. That's what I like to see. I like to see when it's not moving, like when it's like still. That means this is how I am in the morning when I'm making smoothies. Alright, so here's my glass. Yeah, baby, Gigi Slush. Alrighty, so that was a little awkward. That's a little awkward trying to pull it out with my left hand and the spoon. Alright, so. Yeah, I'm liking how this, I'm liking the color of it. I'm liking how it's smelling. I'm liking everything about this drink right now. It's mouth-watering. It just smells refreshing. You don't have to be like me and go all the way to the top. So we're going to slice. I want to slice. For my garnish. And also, some thyme right there. Tell me I don't like that. Tell me I don't like that. You know what this is good for? Your man. You and your man. All right, Jade? So, You have a man? Nah, this hitting. This is hitting. That's hitting right there. I like bourbon and I like whiskey. So this for me is really hitting, is hitting nicely. And you could definitely do this without making it a slushy frozen drink. Like you could definitely I would divide these ingredients in half and put it on the rocks. Or actually, with this kind of glass, you could probably use all the ingredients and just do it on the rocks. Hey, Jovi. Oh my God, you see that? Tell me that look beautiful. Tell me that doesn't look beautiful. That looks beautiful. Yeah, it gives you like a whiskey effect, yeah. Now, if you wanted it, like, you see how it's kind of like melting so quickly? Which is one why I used a frozen glass, a chilled glass to blend it so that I could kind of hold the ice more than if it was like a regular warm glass. But I feel like if you got some citric acid, no, some xanthan gum, excuse me. Citric acid is just to make things a little bit more, to preserve it. Then this would stay and it wouldn't melt as fast. Oh my God, this is definitely refreshing. It's tangy. If you want it to be sweeter, you can definitely add the peach syrup, or you can also add some honey as well. Honey, grapefruit, and thyme goes well. And just drinking this with the smell of the rosemary, which is woody, it's piney, it really just, oh my God, I can't stop. Anybody have any questions? You know, if you didn't want to use ginger ale, which also would be kind of a sweetener, you can just do honey, rosemary, and grapefruit as a drink without the ginger ale. But this is really good. Oh my God. Onto get some. You could just like. Yeah, so main thing, if you want a mocktail that is like whiskey bourbon based, if you have a guy friend and you want to make him something and you're not drinking alcohol but you want to be a great host, then I would use vanilla extract. It really gives the drink that smoky kick that doesn't make it juicy, doesn't make it taste like you're just drinking juice. Oh my God, I love grapefruit. Like, grapefruit, yeah, so grapefruit, I love grapefruit. Like, I feel like I would have grapefruit with brown sugar on it just to kind of balance that tangy taste. Ironically, whenever I'm sick, like, I drink warm grapefruit juice. It tastes like heaven to me when I'm sick. I don't know why. Like, it's just so, I don't want orange juice. I want warm grapefruit juice. But if you are gonna use, Jade, if you're gonna use orange juice in this, you would use the orange juice instead of the vanilla extract. Which would be instead of the bourbon. So if you don't want to use vanilla extract, if you don't want to use bourbon or whiskey, you can use peach syrup as an alternative. You can use orange juice. You can use pineapple juice as an alternative. So those are good replacements, good alternatives for bourbon whiskey. Peach syrup, pineapple juice, orange juice, or vanilla extract. But earlier on, I knew for sure that I really, really wanted to get as close as possible to that smoky bourbon taste, and that's why I used vanilla extract. Hey, Kate, thanks for joining me. We're just wrapping up, but if you didn't check us out earlier, we made this Gigi Slush, which is a grapefruit and ginger ale slush. I was also considering like making my own ginger soda by, you know, boiling water and ginger, and then adding sugar to make a simple syrup, and then adding a seltzer that can be done too. You just have to really figure out those measurements to get you equal to 4 ounces of ginger ale soda. But depending on how you like a ginger ale, really, really sweet, or just like a hint of ginger, or like a really strong taste of ginger and a little less bubbly, really up to you. But just use 4 ounces of it if you want to make your own homemade ginger ale. You can also use ginger beer. All your preferences. Substitute what you like, taste what you like, add different things, shake it up, and decide what you like. Because I know I like the vanilla extract with this. Because again, when I want to drink, and I like these smoky, heavier, darker drinks. So bourbon drinks, whiskey. I like those drinks. I'll drink gin only because you can really get the other flavors of the ingredients out. But bourbon whiskey for me is really a hit. But I'm not really drinking, so it used to be a hit. Hey, Picky. So yeah, we're wrapping up, and thanks for joining. We just finished making this Gigi slush, and I'm really enjoying it. It's really refreshing. It's tangy, slight sweetness because of the ginger ale. It's a definite summer drink because it's frozen. And my favorite part about it is the extract. It's the vanilla extract that we use. That if you don't want to use vanilla extract and you want to use alcohol, you can use your bourbon and whiskey. Oh, my site for the recipe. You're a smart woman. Okay, yeah, we'll get it there. We'll get it there. Hi, Eero. Thanks for joining me, you all, for the Gigi Slush. If you have any suggestions or any recipes you would like me to try and create on IG Live with you all, please do DM me and share. Shen, why are you laughing at me? Yeah, 8 o'clock. You know, I'm like our dad. I'm very on time. And when I'm not on time, I express why I'm not on time. But yeah, again, thank you all. I had a really great time making this with you all. A great meal to pair with this. Well, you know, they say that you usually drink your dark liquors with meat and your lighter liquors with fish, your wine with fish, red wine with darker meat. Let me see, what vegetarian would you use? What vegetarian? I don't know, I thought about nachos. I thought about chips and dip, like guacamole and salsa. But that's an idea. Yeah, vanilla extract. We use ginger ale, grapefruit, and the recipe usually calls for bourbon and whiskey. But instead of bourbon, we used vanilla extract, which still gives it that really great punch. But if you don't need vanilla extract in place of the bourbon or whiskey, you can always use pineapple juice, orange juice, or peach syrup, right? So again, thanks for joining me on this week's Mocktails with Harry for the Gigi Slush. My name is Harry Marie, and you can find me across social at Harry Marie and online at harrymarie.com. And thank you guys. See you guys again. Oh my God, I don't know how to... This is strange. Oh, there it goes. That is so funny. Hi, Kalila, we're ending. You can catch the replay. Thanks.